Kia ora koutou, nau mai haere mai ki ngā pautama mata whenua. Ko Dwayne tēnei. We're going to be looking at how you can create your own online interactive 3D flythrough using ESRI ArcGIS web scenes. ArcGIS Online is a free tool that you can use to create your own 3D flythroughs like this. These are an important building block that can be reused for many different purposes, publications, presentations. And later in this Wananga series, I'll be showing you how to build these into what's called a story map. To begin with, I'm going to exit out of my ArcGIS Online account so that you can see me starting right from the beginning. So the first thing we want to do is go to ArcGIS.com, and you will need to have a free personal ArcGIS Online account. I'm going to go sign in, and I've connected it up with my Google account to save me having to remember a username and password, which is fantastic. Now I'm logged in, there are three key tabs that I need to know. One is for 2D maps. The second is for web scenes, like the 3D one you've just seen. Scene, and content. This is the file manager, where when you've created maps, scenes, and other files, like story maps, you can access these in the content. Today, we're going to be looking at scenes. So the first thing to do is click on scene. And you will see I've got a couple of previous versions. I'm going to create a new one. New scene. Let's have a look around here. Here is the main map, and to navigate, I'm using the left mouse button to do this. Pan. Using the right mouse button, click, hold, click and hold to do this. To look around. And the middle mouse button, or the scroll wheel, to zoom. Zoom in and out with the scroll. If I click and hold, I can just drag and zoom as well. Up at the top here, you can see it's me logged in. Here is the search field. So I can search for whanganui in here. And it's going to give me some options on the drop down. If you're getting results for place overseas, just put a comma and put NZL, and it will bring it back to Aotearoa. Okay, that's the search. Layers. Now in the second stage of this session, I'll be showing you how to add layers, turn them on and off. This is an important one to know. Base maps, we're going to come back to that. Daylight, which allows you to turn the lights on and off. Analyze, which allows you to measure. Share, which of course you can share this with friends and whānau, and it allows you to have a short URL. And here's something to note, I'm going to be using on my computer, on my desktop, on high quality. If you've got a perhaps an older model laptop, or a laptop that is not highly spec'd but just fine for doing most things, you may want to turn the 3D graphics down. And then just make sure you close that. Over on the other side here, you can see this is the file name of this web map that we're currently working in, this web scene. It's called My Scene for now, because I haven't pressed the save button yet, which is just here. Here is where I can add layers, and we'll come to that later. A key part of this exercise is showing you how to add slides. And properties, you'll see this update once we've pressed save. So the first thing I'm going to do is I much prefer to use a base map of satellite imagery. And so I'm going to come onto this four square button. And there's any number of different ones I can use if I want. I can have a dark map if I want. And these are global base maps. This one here, World Imagery, is or World Base Map. This is the one I use almost all the time. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom out to about here, and you can see there's a small grey dot. Now that is because I've got a search term just in there still. So I'm just going to exit out of that, and now I've got a nice clean map. So the first thing I want to do is with this fly through that I'm going to create, I want to start with this view from space because I like it. That's why. It's cool. Why not? Why wouldn't you? Because then you're going to do this massive zoom down to the area that you want. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to zoom down to Whanganui. Now, one thing with some views, you can see here the transition between the satellite imagery and aerial photography. So I'm going to take one step back to make sure that it's nice and clean on my satellite imagery. I'm using the right click to turn and left click to pan. I'm just going to include a slither of the sky, just so that as my audience get used to the view that I'm going to present them with, they're not kind of lost in this massive, awesome zoom down to somewhere in the middle of the island and they can't find where it is. So I'm going to have a pause just here. So I'm going to go capture slide, and this one's going to be called Whanganui. Okay, if I want to fix that, if I wanted to adjust it, let's say I wanted to have a little bit of Taranaki visible. Or if I wanted to turn it the other way, down to Wairarapa, Manawatu, or just something a bit different, or just a minor adjustment. Now, if I just press that button there, update, it will write over the bookmap and give it this new view, default view. Okay, so there's my first slide. It's going to open at orbit. I'm going to press the button and it's going to come down to Whanganui. And now I'm going to go on my tour. Now there's no particular rhyme or reason to this tour. It's just for demonstration purposes to show you how you could create this for your own Pepeha, your own Mōteatea, whatever else you might like to use this for. Cultural storytelling, you name it, you can use it for that. And of course, this is using a free personal account, so all of this is free. So thank you, Esri, for making this available. The next place here is Kaifaiki. Let me see if I can remember. Kaifaiki, there we go. And I'm happy with that view. I'm going to come back up a bit. I'm going to come over here. And if any of you have ever driven up over this hill, you know the little view that I'm aiming for down the awa. There we go. Quite nice view there. So there is no vertical exaggeration in here. This is, if you could manage to hover in a helicopter just here, this would be the scale of the hills. Sometimes too close is not always better. So I'm going to take a step back here and capture slide. And this one is Pongarehu. My next one, going for my hikoi up the awa, is Parakino. And so I want a nice view of this marae. Where I went many years ago, worked with some whānau there. I'm going to call this one Parakino. Okay, and the last one in this tour is up here to one of my favourite little places, Atene. Here we go. Just going to get this just right. Now you can see here, this is the difference between two pieces of aerial photography. You can see here, this one is probably in the summer because the water is quite clean. This one might be in the spring or autumn because the grass, the vegetation is green, but also the awa has got some mud in it as well. So that's all that means. Just different time periods when the airplane flew over to take those photos. Okay, I'm getting where I want it to be. This was the A, Artene. Okay. That's enough for now. Let's have a look at this. We're going to start out at orbit. We're going to go Whanganui. Next, Kai Whaiki. Kia ora Ken. Pangarehu. Parakino. And Artene. Cool. I'm happy with that. And back to Whanganui. Done. Now here's something I should have done way back when I was doing this one. I should have pressed Save Scene. And now that I'm where this one view, this is the thumbnail that I want for this 3D. So I press that little button there and it updates it. Whanganui 3D tour. And description summary, an example of creating a 3D fly through with ArcGIS online for free. And tags, this is so that in a year's time, when I've created 50 or 60 of these, I can easily find all the ones associated with the Whanganui, all the ones that might be containing Parakino or Atene or Pongarehu or Kai Whaiki. Okay. Safe. And the little green item here tells me that it's been successfully saved. Saved to my personal private Esri account, which is free, private. Okay. If I press this pen button, it will just put that part away. So now I can sit here and marvel in the glory of my 3D mahi, which is just awesome. This will also work fine on a phone and a tablet. I'm not certain if you can create these on a phone or a tablet, but you certainly can view them on a phone or a tablet. And to Artene, there we go. Okay, now I want to share this with you. I want you to be able to view this tour. So I come over here and I go share, and it gives me a short URL, short link. Don't type that one in yet because this scene is not shared with the public. People might not be able to view it. Change share settings. So this is my project and I have an about item for this tour. And so what I need to do is I need to make it public. So I can go owner or I can go public. If I have an organizational account, now if you're interested in signing up for, say, a non-profit account, then you can also share it with others in the organization. And in a future session, we'll talk about groups as well. So in this instance, I'm going to make it public. Everyone has access. And go save. Now I can put more description here. It shows the layers that I've used. I can add credits. It tells me here that I should put more information about it, what's called metadata or data about the data. So I'm just going to go in here. This is an example tour for demonstration purposes. Is it purposes or purposes? There we go. And save. And I can put a picture, video, anything I want in there as well. Let's have a look in settings. Nothing much to see here, but I can tick that if I want. What that means is I have to come back into the settings and untick that before it will allow me to delete it. Open in Scene Viewer. I'm going to close the previous scene just so I don't confuse myself. And here you can see my tour. Now I can share this with you now. This is public. You can access this if you want to go to arcgis/1bvq F 0. Then that will allow you to view this. If I come in here and go here and go in a logged out browser, then it's going to open that tour. And this is exactly how you will see it when you open that link. So that link again is just there. If you want to pause the video, you can open that and you'll be able to do this for yourself, for your own Pepeha, for your own Mōteatea, your own story, whatever you want to do with that. Okay. E kona mai, mā te wā, ka kite.